combined also vertical journalism. So even to combine with the node editor or with different tools and different physics, different simulation, because there is the bullet engine and there is the other simulations, the modifiers, and the particles. Yeah, that's it. We'd like to know if people have questions or suggestions or opinions. Constraints. So they are being attached. When you start to climb, you have like a property called climb. Zero means it's not climbing, one is climbing up, and two is climbing, one is X is rotating like this, and two is rotating like this. And you also use in Python, you use the function to look if it's parallel to the normal. You get the normal and they see how much degrees, and if it's not parallel, you always try to balance yourself.
Okay, so you use Python to align the normals.
Yeah, Python, and in the end, when you start to climb, you don't use the attach constraint, because then you couldn't attach to the set, to the next object. But, so you disconnect, but once it's recognized and almost aligned, you use the attach and it's attaching back. One thing also that I forgot to mention about climbing. When you climb up, you rotate, but when you climb back, you use the ground sensor. And when you see that there is no ground under him, the Python says, okay, slow down. Look, if there is no ground, make your like rotate back and then attach again.
Okay. did you plan to use a global walking mesh for all agents to make better pathfinding? Did you plan to make a walking mesh for all agents? Now it's difficult objects where we can climb up and down, but for fast pathfinding, so that they get the shortest path, or that they can go back to a labyrinth, it may be easier to make a global warp mesh to calculate the fastest way where they have to go. For pathfinding.
Yeah. Yeah, I know it's using this target as pathfinding. From what I saw, just clearing the actuator, it has